The human body is a fortress designed to keep the outside world out. In our daily lives, we're constantly exposed to disease-causing organisms called pathogens that want to get inside of our bodies and take a permanent residence there. And why wouldn't they? We're warm, moist, and full of delicious nutrition that they can take advantage of. Since infections have the potential to make us really sick or kill us, humans have developed many protections with the purpose of eliminating anything foreign that enters the body. This is our immune system, which is present at full force in what are called common portals of entry. These are areas that are consistently exposed to the environment, like the gastrointestinal, reproductive, or respiratory tracts. These parts of the body are well protected by layers of cells called epithelia that are tightly associated with one another, like bricks in a fortress wall. Epithelial layers are impenetrable to practically everything, but especially to invasive organisms that would happily squeeze into the paradise inside of us. Human cells lining these tracts also produce lots of mucus to coat themselves, which can trap microorganisms. Coughing and blowing the nose actually helps to remove large amounts of microbes, keeping us a step ahead of the fight. The less of them that there are inside of us, the less likely we are to be taken over. Every once in a while, some pathogens end up breaching these barriers and get into our system. At that point, it's up to a huge army of immune cells that are employed by the human body to seek and destroy the infection, and this can happen in a few different ways. The most common is for immune cells to consume the microorganism and digest it to kill it, a process called phagocytosis. Another more direct mechanism of killing is when immune cells fire off chemicals that are toxic to pathogens. These are usually in the form of granules, which can destroy the cell wall and the cell membrane of invading organisms, causing their insides to spew out in a very gruesome death. These are just a few of the many effective strategies that a host has to protect itself from being overtaken by outside entities. In Lifeforce, you might think that you're the good guy. You play a fighter ship pilot trying to save his planet from the belly of a giant alien beast named Zelos who's been consuming everything in sight, including your entire civilization. Although the pilot's quest to rescue everyone from their fate is admirable from his perspective, to Zelos, you're an invasive threat that's trying to kill him, and his immune system isn't going to take that very lightly. Since you've been eaten, you logically begin the game in Zelos' intestinal tract in Cell Zone 1. The area looks very much alive as we fly along the intestinal lumen with walls of the tract covered in villi. These are long projections that extend to help with water and nutrient absorption in normal digestion. In humans, the gastrointestinal tract is one of the most highly guarded areas given just how many foreign to us foods we put into our bodies on a regular basis. Food particles, their digested components, and microorganisms that might be present on them all make their way into our alimentary canal, and it's our immune system's job to make sure that we don't get sick as a result of what we eat. There are also small cells floating around that are likely one of many white blood cells that participate in the immune response. Some of the first cells to respond to a new invasion are macrophages. These cells are phagocytic, and although they don't actually ingest the foreign ship here, they do harm it through physical contact, which is another offensive mechanism of many different immune cell types. There are other cell-like organisms called jellips walking along the villi, seemingly patrolling the area. Dendritic cells are similar to this in that they act as messengers that collect information about threats to the host and go off to relay the message to other immune cells in faraway places. When news of the intruder spreads, tons of other fighter cells are recruited to the place in the body where that first encounter was to eliminate the problem, which in our case is the little starship blowing up everything in its path. In the next area, there are a ton of objects targeting the starfighter in an effort to destroy it. A subset of immune cells in humans are granulocytes, and these contain toxic particles. When granules come into contact with the invaders, they compromise the integrity of a microorganism structure and cause it to die almost immediately. The Moe enemies here are very similar to this, with their numerous released projectiles aimed directly at the starship to take it down. As we ascend Zelos a little further, we're treated to a bombardment with what the manual calls the volcanic and prominence areas. In the human body's defense repertoire, tactics are not only limited to physical barriers or specialized cell activities like we've been discussing here, but also includes chemical warfare like adapting environmental pH. Increasing or decreasing pH to make conditions basic or acidic can have a tremendously negative effect on living things, and the literal fire in the prominence area is reminiscent of the stomach's corrosive pH of 2. If we happen to ingest pathogenic bacteria from our food, stomach acid normally kills most of them. In Lifeforce's prominence area, our ship is tasked with avoiding the barrage of fireballs, spitballs, and phoenix enemies that are trying to melt him down like a good host defense should. The next section is very obviously a diversion to the bloodstream, since erythrocytes, or red blood cells, make their debut there. When things finally slow down after rocketing through a labyrinthine section of Cell Stage 2, the starfighter is faced with large projections that extend into the lumen from the walls of the vessels. If these sacs are not immediately destroyed, they release many cells into the immediate environment. These are similar to lymph nodes, which are found all throughout the trunk of the body and are the primary location where immune cells are recruited, multiplied, and activated to join the fight against invaders. Not too long later, our hero has to contend with blasting his way through tight meshworks that are very similar to the thread-like makeup of blood clots. The human immune system forms temporary clots in our blood vessels to wall off an infection and to keep it contained so that it can't easily spread elsewhere. The threads of fibrin are woven together to create a net to catch and keep invaders in one place until other cells can come to kill them, similarly to the mucus that we discussed earlier. In the temple stage, we're introduced to another massive force working against our starship. These are Zelos' former victims that have been forced to live inside of him for the long haul. There's a great comparison to humans here in what are called commensal organisms or native flora. These are bacteria that live in and on us in a relationship that is symbiotic in nature, meaning that both we and the bacteria inside of us benefit from living together. Civilizations that have been eaten by Zelos are now a part of him and obviously don't want their new home to be destroyed. If Zelos dies, then it's possible that they might too, so of course they're going to do everything in their power to make sure that the starfighter doesn't succeed in his mission. The residents here are very well established and unleash a huge onslaught of offensive projectiles that hone in on the ship as it makes its way through the area, similarly to how commensal bacteria will attack pathogens entering a host because they don't want to share space or nutrients with them. Also featured in this stage are antibodies. These are Y-shaped proteins that work as opsonins to stick to and coat the surface of an invader. Opsonins signal to immune cells that something's wrong and call in backup to take out the identified pathogen, and here they can be seen seeking out the ship as well since it's a threat to the host. The last stretch of the game, the Mechanical City stage, is an extension of what we saw in Stage 5. This final civilization goes all out with homing attacks via torturous Iron Maiden enemies, as well as a flurry of projectiles from other symbionts in a last-ditch effort to take down the ship as it approaches the core of Zelos. When an infection in humans progresses to major systems and organs, they can end up dying from complications, just like poor Zelos here, who has his heart and soul pummeled by the starship. After a narrow escape by our hero, life for all other threatened civilizations that were on Zelos' menu can finally return to normal. Even though it feels like we've saved the day for millions of space residents for generations to come, it's really hard not to feel bad for our giant host monster. He was just an alien with an insatiable appetite that happened to eat the wrong guy and all of his friends. After all, he was just living his life while his immune response was doing its best job to protect him. It really gets you thinking about who the real villain was here. Zelos or the pilot? What do you guys think?